Welcome, Advent of Code. We are solving the last 2 days today, day 24, day 25. Let's start by checking our private leaderboard. Probably most of the people there have solved it already. Yeah. I am 2 tasks behind. And this is what we need to fix today. So let's start by reading them. Problem definition. Arithmetic logic unit. Magic smoke starts leaking from the submarine's arithmetic logic unit. Without the ability to perform basic arithmetics and logic functions, the submarine can't produce cool patterns with Christmas lights. Also can't navigate. You probably have enough oxygen left to give you enough time to build a four-dimensional. Four-dimensional, oh my god. It has integer variable W, X, Y, Z. These variables all start with value 0. I'll use source 6 instruction, read an input value and write the variable A. Add the value of A to the value of B. Then store result into variable A. Multiply, divide. Divide A with value B, then store remainder. Okay, so this is quad, this is mod. Is value B equal, store value on the way. Okay. A and B are place corners. A will always be the variable where result of the operation stored one of W, X, Y, Z, while B can match the variable on our not going to put the negative, but will always be integers. The ALU has no jump instructions. It's every instruction is run exactly once in order from top to bottom. The program halts after the last instruction is finished. Program author should be especially cautious attempting to execute diff with B equals 0, attempting to move with A code word to crash. No new damage will use. This version is not intended to any series in the program. Okay. Okay, so inputs are read from left to right. Okay, cool. Okay, so we have this program, okay? Probably need to implement it. Hi, closure guy. Pretty good, pretty good. Yes, we celebrated Christmas with some German family. It was cool. Okay, so we built a program, right? Right. And then we tested on different inputs. Like building this program is not hard. What's hard is Okay, so program is probably program is something is like something that takes WXYZ and input. Try to analyze the code. Why? You think I don't need to write a program? No, let's write a program. I would like to write a program. Well, basically, INP is going to take this is our input, there is add the AB, add the AB. Well, we can actually make this a map. diff with b equals 0, mod with a was 0. Maybe we also want the line number. Right. Yeah, we can increase line number, I think. We can put line number in here. Line number. Keys input line. State. Okay. Now we need to parse and build the program, I think. That so basically we start with a function that takes an input, right? Input, and it converts it into w0, x0, y0, z0. Line 1 and input map parse long input, right? This is the function that we start with, and what we do with it, like say we see an input. We return a function takes input. So op could be, for example, imp, right? Yes, no. Div mod equal. Right, and say there's no input, right? Well, there is. Let program parse input, right? And now, for example, we pass something like this. Oh, I forgot to add. Okay, null pointer exception, multiply somewhere. This looks legit. It will be a very nested program. Day 24, 38. The problem with it is we need to do try catch somehow, right? Defend ourselves. Yeah, because I forgot. Because I Okay. Let's add a prefix. Or we can actually use okay, so this program works. All right. And our task is to find like the biggest program that doesn't work. For some reason this line is 239. Why is this line wrong? I don't understand. Okay, I know, somehow it's always the same. Something doesn't work, apparently. Okay, somehow we don't consume input. Somehow we don't consume input. Why? The space is optional. Oh my god. Okay, now we can see our input, right? But still, all programs kind of work. Get to the end. Is this the answer? Let's check. It's not that. Okay, fair enough, fair enough, but again, if I do this, I get this execution trace, right? So we write 9, then what do we do? We multiply x by 0. We add x and z, like this are like no ops, right? X equals w. Can it be solved by binary search? Well, I still have to see why it doesn't fail my program. But from what I see, x is going to be 10, 0, 1. This doesn't depend on input at all, like first few operations. Okay, so let's see. Maybe okay, let's see again. Input W, right? Well, maybe we should move spy to the right. Like this, so it will be more natural to read. Okay, so now what we do is input W, W is 9, multiple X, add XZ, mod. X26 div z1 add x10 x is 10 equal xw no because w is one digit so it's never true it's always zero. Okay, let's find an operation that might fail. Mod x26. Div z1. Okay. From what I see, there are no negative numbers in this program, so I wonder. So maybe I read the problem statement wrong. So variable z is, so we have to look at z. Okay, now I get it. I for some reason I assumed it must fail. It actually not. Okay, so let's say do seek E so we start with this, right? We go to this minus one, let model string is string model when matches 1 9 class another string. Let state program another string. Okay, I think program should treat input as a string and like this. Okay. When print len model string state. Okay, let's do it here. So this is our exit condition, right? Printing too much. And it also might fail actually. This all goes into try. We'll have exception E. Just out of curiosity, I'm going to bring some exceptions as well. Binary search. Well, binary search is possible. No. Well, I guess it's possible. Well, we don't know. Really? It would be possible if we could find some, if we had some reasonable way to find working solutions. Like, until we find one working solution, there is nothing to talk about. It's as good as guesses. Right. Like, let's say some reason key repeat doesn't work for me, but I guess we're supposed to analyze a program after all. Okay, so maybe looks like it doesn't depend. It's bigger, right? No, I don't see. Okay, let's analyze the program. Okay, so this doesn't depend on W, so we can remove it. Day 24 annotated. So this is, I'm not reading the spoilers, sorry, and this is nothing, this is nothing, this is nothing, this is x equals 10, but because of this, so basically this first one sets equals basically x equals 1, right? Then multiply y by 0, add y by 25, multiply y by x, 26, z is 0 at that point. So this all is pretty much useless, right? Because z is 0, right? So basically here y equals w plus 1. Um, multiplied by x, which is 1 always at this point. Okay, add zy, so in this case z equals w equals 1 as well. Okay. Then, well, or d0, right, digit 0, input w, multiple x1, so x is 0 again, then we add x to z, right, mod x 26, so this is basically no op. Div z1 is no op, x plus 11. Okay, so x equals digit 0 plus 12 at this point. There is no way, so x equals 1 again. What the fuck? Y equals 0. X is 1, 26, z, multiple z by y, okay, so here z equals digit 0, multiple 26 plus 1, plus 26. Oh, it's actually digit 1, finally. Actually, it's digit 1 plus 9. X is 1. Z. D digit 0, multiple 26, plus digit 1, plus 35. Five, kind of, input w, so w digit 2, x, yeah, they're kind of the same. This number is different, right? Okay, let's try to write a formula of this. Basically, we are saying x equals z mod 26, z equals z quad 26, x minus plus minus 4. Okay, that's then two equals. So if x is equal w, if this is true 1, then we write one and zero, right? Basically, this is not relevant. Not equals w, right? So if it's not equals w, we will have 0, 1, yeah, okay. Y is 25 multiple x plus 1. Z is It doesn't make much sense. And this has to be like 0, right? Yeah, it was a very hard task. The hardest for this year. And somehow we need to figure out a way for this to be zero after this going through 14 of such operations. So x is either 1 or 0, right? But the problem is with z is that it it accumulates, right? Maybe we can build such formulas. Backwards. Okay, so let's start with this. I input W, right? Stand. So for example, look here, X is clearly 0, then 10, which means it doesn't equal W, no matter which way it is, right? So it means it's 1 here. Basically, yeah, X is 1. Y is 25, Z is 0, still, right? Z is W plus 1. Okay, so this is after the first formula, it's basically digit 0 plus 1. Okay. Let me take a break real quick. Okay, we simplified the first block. There are 13 more to go. So let's see. X equals digit 0 plus 1. Mod 26, well, it will leave it exactly at that, right? But then we add 11, which means it's 12. Which means it's again, it's not equal to the thingy. So it's 1. Right, so it's 1. Y equals 25, 26. 25, 26. So Z equals digit 0. Multiple 26 plus 26, right? This is Z. Then we say Y equals digit 1 plus 9. Multiple y by x and zy, so we add here, right? So it's 26 plus 9 35. So this is what we are leaving the first thing. What the heck is this sound? Okay, next is kind of the same. Multiply x by 0, add x to z, modulo 26, right? So it's basically this. Modulo 26. So this will give us 0, right? Or not? Yes. This will give us 0. This will give us basically d1, because it's less than 26 and 35 minus 26 is 9. So it's like digit 1 plus 9 plus 14, which leaves 23. Again, is it equals? Probably not. So x is 1, y is 26. So we multiply z by 26 again, right? Twenty-six by twenty-six, 35 by 26. This happens here, right? Oops. So now y equals w plus 12. D2 plus 12. We can move D2 here. Who cares? 35 times 26 plus 12. 9 to 12. Okay. Imagine if I make a mistake somewhere, how cool would that be? Plus 35 is wrong. Are you fucking kidding me? Let's redo it again. So it's 26 here, right? Y equals 26, 0 equals 0. Then we put digit d0 in here. Okay, so this is right, right? Now here, why do we have 35? Okay, let's start. So is 26 plus 11. Oh, it's 37. No, wait. Okay, so restart x equals digit 0 plus 1, right? Plus 12, actually. Okay, so x is 1. Y equals 26, right? So we multiply z by 26. So z is going to be d0 times 26 plus 26, right? By this time. No. Wait. We have 26 left from here. Right? Like, see, we have d0 here plus 1. So that is d0 plus 1, right? For the first block. The second block, we say we multiply the previous value by 26, right? Y is 26, we multiply it by 26, so we get this one. Then we get y equals d1 plus 9. And then we add z2. Like if we add these two, we will get this one, right? No, I think it's all right. What do you mean y 26? Because z was d0 plus 1, and we multiply z by y, and y is 26. No, I don't think it's wrong. I think it's correct. Maybe it doesn't matter in the future, like it's always, I don't know. We can actually check, or we can run the program for with spy. Like this, right? And see the values. Like, let's run it with 1 to 3 in 3 first 3 digits. So wait, this is not. Yeah, this is correct. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so where is? So by the end of this, z equals 2, which means d0, 1 plus 1, right? Z equals 2. Okay. Then after the second block here, it's 63. And my formula gives me 26 plus 2 plus 35, 63. Yeah. We can even check the third block. Here it gives 1653, which would be 1 multiple 26 multiple 6 plus 2 multiple 26 plus 3 plus 2 total. 1653, yeah, it's correct. Okay, this block, right? X equals Z, modulo 26. So basically it means X equals D2 plus 9 to 2 mod 26, which is 12, apparently. So again, there is no way it could be equal to a digit, right? No way. Like for 9, it will give us 21. It will not go over 26. Any way. Okay. And there is also add 13. Okay, so add 13 means we are not going over. Okay, so it doesn't matter. Y equals 25, 26. So we multiply this by 26, 26, 26, 26, right? Plus D3 plus 6. So basically, we move D3 here. Two, three, nine, seven, eight. 2, 3, 9, 7, 8. Okay. Okay, the first interesting block because we get add x minus 6 here, which is could be interesting. Possibly our first. How could z be equal to anything in this case? Okay, but yeah. So x is z, modulo 26. So basically, x is d3, 2, 2, 3, 9. A mod 26 is 6 plus 6. Okay. Whoa. And then we divide that by 26. What? 1, 1, 1, 1, 26. Okay. Okay, this is unusual actually. We add x minus 6. So x is just z3. Basically branch, right? D3 equals D4. So this is important difference in our case. And also notice that z was divided z by 26, which means something like that. 3 plus 6 divided by 26. Okay. I mean, so far I just don't see any other way. It's pretty straightforward actually. Why? But I'm not sure how we should approach this. Kind of like this, right? So this will always be zero, right? Because even 9 plus 6, so this is going to be zero. Okay. So z3 is ignored by this point, but if d4 equals d3, okay, so what will happen? So we can have x equals 1 or 0 here, right? If it equals 1, it means it doesn't equal, right? If 1 means doesn't equal. Okay, so if it's 1, we get this multiplied by 26. Right, plus d4. Plus 9. Yes. Kind of like this, right? 23. Yeah, okay. So let's leave it like that. Some like operations will be easier, maybe. Maybe. But if it equals d4, x will be 0, which means y will be 1 here, so z stays z. So Z stays Z basically. Alright, so we don't have D3, doesn't look like we will have D3 anywhere in the output, but what's important if it's equals to 24 or not. Okay, so D3, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is D3, this is D4, right? Okay, so if my theory is correct, yeah, we get everything correct but this number. Okay, so if it's different, okay, let's actually compare like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try to see what we should get. It's 26 by 26 plus 2 by 26 plus 3 plus 9 to power. Okay, so this is what we are going to get. This is 1, 2, 3, 5, 5. It's not D4. Okay. But if they are equal, it doesn't matter what, like 5, 5, right? 9, 9, yeah. Okay, 5, 5. One, six, five, three. One, six, five, three. This is not what we're getting, right? We're getting something different. Okay, so I forgot something. So X is zero. This means zero, one, so we leave Z as it is. Then we add W plus 9, multiply by 0 again. Oh, no, multiply by X. Yeah, multiply by X, X is 0. And okay, so this is confusing. Okay, let's do 4, 5. And in case 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it's going to be this plus 2, 26, 26, plus 3, 26, plus 4, not 4, 5, right? Plus 9, 2, 2, times 26, plus 9. But something is wrong here. Or not. Something is wrong here. Oh, because I'm comparing the final step. We shouldn't be comparing final step. This is merely in the 2, 3, 4, 5. This is after line 90 or something, right? Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 after line 90. 4, 2, 9, 2, 2. Yes? Yes. And 1, 2, 3, 5, 5 after line 90. 1657. Okay, correct. So good. Good so far. Okay, but it makes moving forward harder. Fuck. Because now we don't know what Z is, right? Because now it's like two possibilities, and we have to branch. And possibly branch again here. Okay, let's see. Let's see. No, that's okay. X is Z. Let's copy this. In our case, if d3 equals d4, x, we try to divide this by 26, right? X will be this. Oh, modulo, actually, modulo. Modulo. It's d2, and 2 mod 26, 12 plus 12. Minus 14. Minus 14, right? So it's basically d2 minus 2 and if D2 minus 2 D5, fuck me. It feels like we should try to make to take first branch, not the second branch, right? Because second branch, like, it grows. Like, for okay, so see, for the second branch, x equals 0, 0, 0, like, basically d4 plus 9. Is plus 9, yes, minus 14, so it's d4 minus 5, right? Okay, now I don't like the branches. But let's say we always want to go for the branches where x is small, for example, right? Maybe. Okay, but if this is true, z is, we need to say d0 times 26 plus d1 plus 92 quad 26. 12 5. So this is always 0, right? zero multiple z by y plus w okay. So far we have this formula. Okay, now our conditions are d3 equals d4, d5 equals d2 minus 2, right? z equals d0 times 26 plus d1 plus 35. Okay. Unfortunately, here nine. Okay, so basically we leave z as is, right? X is always 0 or 1 here. So basically what we're saying is we don't care what X is, right? Yeah, no, we only care about Z. So Z again is going to be D0 times 26 plus D1 times 26 plus 35 times 26 plus W, which is D6 plus 7. Okay. Can see Z got multiplied again, 26 plus D7 plus 12, right? This is basically 23,854. Okay. So let's see. D2 minus 2. So basically, let's say we want 1, 2. Three, four. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 1. This is just 6 numbers, right? 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, let's run on this input. And we are interested in at Y12 on line 142, or line 145 probably. 145, 42, 8, 1, 9. Okay, so let's see. 1, 2, 6, and 7. Wait, what? 1, 2, 3, 4. We actually defined 6 and 7. 7, 8. So let's say like this, right? Okay, when we need 145, this is value that we get. D6 basically is 7, right? This is 8. 42, yeah, so far so good. Okay. And we're trying not to grow too fast, kind of. Oops. Okay, now we have kind of the same x at the x mod x26, so basically x is going to be d7, sorry, ic mod 26, 12 plus 12, right? And then we'd say minus 8, and this is supposed to be equals to the 8. Okay. And z is divided by 26 again, which means we remove this, we remove this, we remove this. Basically, this is 'What's up, nerds? W24 was my favorite day. Are you fucking kidding me? This is not fun. I'm trying to fucking solve this program by hand. Okay. And I'm not even sure I'm doing the correct premise. Like, I'm guessing this makes sense. Like, too much branching, and I'm just taking one branch and going with it, right? So in this case, for example, we do modulo 26, 7. Um, 15. Minus 15, okay, minus 15, minus 15. I simply wrote 250 lines to Rust. And like how did it help you? Minus 15, okay. 15 minus 7 is minus 8. So basically, this is minus 8. And we want D9 B equals D6 minus 8. I am from Russia, but I am living in Berlin now. And we need to divide this by 26, right? So like this 35. I also wrote to Rust but didn't run into it once. I even just once realized that it's working like a stack machine in base 26. No, I realized it works like a stack machine in base 26. I guess. Okay, here we take x. Well, we don't take, so we probably multiply this by 26 again. Plus d10 plus 6, right? Are we close? Not really. Not really. So at this point we are supposed to have like 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. D5 equals d2 minus 2, so 1. D6 is supposed to be like 8 or 9 or something. 8, for example. No, 9, 9. Then 1, 1, right? This is. Then, for example, 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so if we run it like this. And we go to what we are going to get is 26 by 26 plus 2 by 26 plus 35 by 26 plus d10, which is 1 plus 6. 1, 6, 4, 5. 1, 6, 4, 5. Hopefully, right? So, and this should happen after line 198, 43, 11. No. Okay, I fucked up somewhere. Okay, cool to know that you fucked up. let's move 180. 1654. Okay. So this is the answer for actually. Okay, I messed up somewhere. There was 63 in okay, I messed up somewhere. Like this we checked, right? And wait, why is okay, so like supposedly after 144 we see. Well, like if I do it like this, supposedly this is correct, right? So, like, why is this not correct? Or did I not check it? Okay, let's check this condition. So 144, the next one 162. 162 gives us this number. And in our case, it will be 26 plus 26, 2 by 26, D6, 9. Okay, so here we are wrong somehow. Or maybe I didn't make some condition correct. Oh no, yeah, condition is wrong. Fuck. So D8 is d7 minus 8. So basically, this is d7 minus 8, like this, right? And in our case, d9, which is this, right? No, this is d6. And we want to find, or we can even wait, this is d5. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. This is 5. d5 is 1. This is 6, right? This is 7. This is 8 and this is 9. This is correct, actually. But like I get what's going on, but I need to figure out these conditions, right? And conditions branches, like if you take one branch or another branch, they change. And I hope that popping the stack is the right approach always, but it might not be the case, so it's like shot in the dark, basically. Because I couldn't rake every possible branch. And somehow I'm stuck somewhere. Like d8 is d5, right? This is d8. D6, which we'll later touch. This is supposed to be D7. This is supposed to be D8, right? And if we go 26 plus 2 plus D6. In our case, 3, d6 is 9. Okay, and this is after at x minus 9. So which means line 162. 162. No. Okay, this is right, right? We have 7, 8 here. Let's put this one instead of line 162. Let's look at line 144. And it has this, right? Does it work with our formula? 1, 2, 1, 9, 42, 8, 17. No, it doesn't work. What the fuck? I don't know. Let's check this one. Maybe this one is wrong, right? This is was line 144, so let's look at line 126. And it has 1654, okay. Let's put it into our formula, which will be 1 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, so this is wrong as well. Wait, this, which is D6? 1, 2, 3. Okay, this is D0, right? Basically, okay, so this is 9. Okay, this works 9. So D6 is 9. And the 7 is 9 as well. In this case, so 3. Okay, so here it works. Okay, good. And here it doesn't, right? So let's redo this. So we have this. So let's say x starts the same. We do modulo 26, which basically leaves us modulo 26 with plus 12. Then we do minus 8, so it's plus 4. And it's supposed to be equal to d8, right? So d8. Yeah, this condition is wrong. And z, we divide z by 26. Okay, so this. Okay, so let's say we have this number. This is d6. This is d7. Let's say it's 5, then this could be 9, right? And this is d8, 9, yes. And what we were supposed to see is 1 multiple 26 multiple 26 plus 2 times 26 plus 6, which is 9 plus 9, 16, equals 1, 6, 5, 3, 1, 6, 5, 3. And this is add x minus 8, so it's 162. 1, 6, 5, 4, right? Does it match? Almost. Wait, what? Okay, now, okay, this is, was this, right? Okay, 1, 6, 5, 3, so this matches, okay, cool. Now this branch, we maybe did it wrong. Okay, so X is this modulo 26, so basically 9, 17 modulo 26, which is 7, right? Minus 15, 7 minus 15 is minus 8, minus 8, and this is D9, right? This is D9. I hope. Now this was D8, so this is D9. D6 minus 8. Okay, so D6 is this, and D9 is this. So basically 1, right? So, okay. And Z in our case would be this, 9, 17 divided by 26 is 35. Okay, let's see. We use this number, we run x minus 15, we look at line 180. 180, it gives us 63, and our formula gives us 126 plus 2 plus 35. Yeah, 63. Okay, so this works so far. Now this. Okay. So this is what we used to have, right? So Z, we doesn't change Z. X is definitely not equals. So we just multiply by 26 everything, right? Plus D10 plus 6, kind of. So this is going to be 1 plus 2 plus D10, which is in our case 1, right? Is D9, is D10, because case it's 1. Okay. 1, 6, 4, 5, 1, 6, 4, 5. And we need to look at the line 1, 8, 1, 6, 4, 5. It kind of works. Okay, cool. Are we close? I'm kind of tired. Okay, let's try this again. So we start with X, which is this, right? We do modulo 26, which basically removes this. We do minus 11, 6 minus 11 is minus 5. And this is D11, right? Yeah, this is D11. So D11 is D10 minus 5. In our case, D10 is this. So biggest it can be 6. So D11 can be 1. And Z in this case would be, we divide by 26. Right? So it's kind of this, and 1, 26, plus 2, plus 35. So if our calculations are correct, we need to get 63 on this number here on the line of 216, right? 216 is here. Yeah, we get 63. Okay. Well, this is good news, I think. We're almost there. So we divide Z again. Okay, let me do this. So X is modulo 26, which means modulo 26 is 9. Plus 9, minus 13, 9 minus 13 is minus 4, minus 4, and this is D12, is D1 minus 4, D1 minus 1, okay. And Z is basically plus 1, right? On the two left, but I'm suspicious of where is it going, because again I'm not doing branching properly. Okay, so D12 must be equals to D1 minus 4, so we set 5 here, 1 here, and in this case it should be 6, right? Okay, and we are looking at the line minus 13, at the line 234, 234, 167, okay. No, something is wrong. So this was correct, right? So we kind of D1 minus 4, D12 is this. Ah, D1 minus 4, oh my god. Okay, so let's set 5 here. Okay, should be more careful next time, and we are looking at 66. No, now it's supposed to be 2, and it is 2, right? It is 2. Okay. And final advance is, we try to make, this is basically X. Which is D0 plus 1. If we do modulo 26, it's the same. If we do minus 4, it's going to be minus 3. And this is D13. Okay, so D13 is D0 and Z equals 0 in this case. Okay, so this is how we find 0, right? So supposedly if this is 4, we get 0 in the end, right? Yeah, we get 0, cool. Okay, so this feels like it works. So let's start with 9. That means the last one is going to be 9 minus 3, 6, right? Then we're going to be 9, 5. D11 and D10 are going to be, like, we need the maximum we can get. So in our case, it's D10. It's 6 and 1, right? So D9 is going to be 1 and D6 is going to be 9. next d7 and d8. So d8 is probably going to be 9 again, and 9 minus 4 is 5. So this is d7 is 5. d5 is d2 minus 2, so we put 9 here and 7 here and 2 9s here. Okay. Fuck! So we need to do branching, right? We need to do branching somehow. This gives us zeros, right? Okay, what if I start with this? How long will it take to do this? It's pi. So it did found some numbers, okay. I don't know. This feels super stupid. And we have part two as well again. Check it against the formula. Check what against the formula? Yeah, let's see. But no, this is not going to be... Oh no, I was stupid. Yeah. Somehow I made... Of course. Yeah, no, formula was right. I was stupid. Formula was right. I didn't put it for D10 and D11. I didn't put the maximum. I put minimum somehow. No, I tried to counting down from 99999. No, I didn't found it. No, not really. Okay, it still hasn't finished. So even this range, it still hasn't finished. Okay. As the submarine starts booting, you realize. So you say you was able to try all the numbers like in half of this range? Wow. No, yeah, that's true. I didn't optimize, but and probably it's faster in Rust, but I don't know. What is the smallest model number? Okay, so let's use this formula. Again, this time we try to do the smallest ones. Okay, so it's probably 4-1, right? Five one. What? And 12, so we want this to be 1 and this one to be 6, right? Then we have d9 and d6 minus 8, so not really much of a choice. D7 plus 4. So this is d7 is 1, this is 5, right? d2 minus 2, so d2 is probably 3, and d5 is 1, and here 1, 1. Okay, let's see. Okay, I think this is the smallest number. Phew! Okay. Okay, I don't know how to write this down, but I suppose it's just like this. I don't even know what to say, like, parse the instructions expression trees for Z in the 14 stages, try all digits for the first stage, look at the Z radius reproduced for each Z radius in the previous stage, and then try all digits. No, I don't understand it. Like, I had no idea without, like, understanding all this. How do you get to any value that has that produces zero? Like you need all 14 digits, you need to, something to start from, right? Two and a half hours, still better than 4 hours the other day, right? Better. But I mean, I don't know. Not my definition of fun, actually. I like writing programs and like executing programs in my head. Okay, let's solve the last one, and I think my will is broken and I will never try invent of code again.